Henri Joseph de Montcalm Grosen, Marquis de Montcalm de Saint-Véran, was a French soldier best known as the commander of the forces in North America during the Seven Years' War, whose North American theater is also referred to as the French and Indian War. Montcalm was born near Nîmes in France on 28 February 1712 to a noble family, and entered military service early in life. He saw service in the War of the Polish Succession and the War of the Austrian Succession, where his distinguished service led to promotion to Brigadier General. In 1756, King Louis XV sent him to New France to lead its defense against the British in the Seven Years' War. Montcalm met with notable successes in 1756, 1757 and 1758, but British mobilization of large numbers of troops against New France led to military setbacks in 1758 and 1759, when, in January, he was promoted to Lieutenant General. He joined the French army in 1721 as an ensign in the Regiment Hainaut. On the death of his father in 1735, he became the Marquis de Saint-Véran, inheriting the honors, rights, and debts of that position. His finances improved soon after by his marriage to Angélique Louise Talon du Boulay. Despite a marriage arranged for money and influence, they were a devoted couple. They made their home at Candiac and had a large number of children, of whom five survived to adulthood. His father purchased a captaincy for him in 1729, and he served in the War of the Polish Succession, seeing action at the 1733 Siege of Kehl and the 1734 Siege of Philippsburg. When the War of the Austrian Succession broke out in 1740, his regiment was stationed in France, so Montcalm, seeking action, took a position as an aide-de-camp to Philippe Charles de La Fère. Montcalm and François Gaston de Lévy were both in the Siege of Prague. He was promoted to colonel of the Regiment d'Auxerrois in 1743. He took part in Marshal de Mailboy's Italian campaigns, where he was awarded the Order of St. Louis in 1744-3, and taken prisoner in the 1746 Battle of Piacenza after receiving 5 sabre wounds while rallying his men. He was released on parole after several months of imprisonment, and promoted to brigadier for his actions during the 1746 campaign. After prisoner exchanges made possible his return to active service, he joined the Italian campaign again in 1747. He was wounded again by a musket ball in the Battle of Assietta, and assisted in raising the siege of Ventimiglia in October. When Marshal Belleisle retired that winter, his army was left under the command of its brigadiers, including Montcalm. The war came to an end in 1748 with the signing of the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle. In 1749 he was awarded a rare opportunity to raise a new regiment in peacetime. The Regiment de Montcalm was a cavalry regiment that Montcalm occasionally inspected. The following year, Montcalm achieved his greatest military success to date with the taking of Fort William Henry. Vaudreuil drew up plans for Montcalm that ordered him to march south and take the British bases south of Lake Champlain, Fort William Henry and Fort Edward a few miles further south. From Fort Carillon, Montcalm and a force of 6,200 regulars and militia, along with 1,800 natives, set upon Fort William Henry on the 3rd of August 1757. The fort was besieged for 3 days before surrender. Under the terms of the surrender, the garrison was to be escorted back to Fort Edward, where they would be barred from serving against the French for 18 months, and all British prisoners were to be returned to the French, who also kept all the stores and ammunition. However, as the garrison left Fort William Henry, they were attacked by natives, and nearly 200 of the 2,000 prisoners were either taken or killed, breaching the terms of surrender. Montcalm decided not to advance onto Fort Edward despite the demoralization of the British forces and the proximity of the fort, claiming the road was too bad for his heavy guns and that the garrison would be reinforced before they arrived. This decision infuriated Vaudreuil, furthering the deterioration of their relationship. While riding back towards the city, General Montcalm was hit in the back by a musket shot. Assisted by 3 soldiers, he regained the city, where he was taken before a surgeon, who announced Montcalm would not live through the night. During the afternoon, The general drew on his last reserves of strength and signed his last official act as commander of the French army in Canada. In a letter addressed to General Wolfe, who unbeknownst to him had also fallen in battle, Montcalm attempted to surrender the city, despite the fact he did not hold the authority to do so. He died at around 5 a.m. on the 14th of September 1759. At 8 a.m., he was buried in a shell hole under the choir of the Ursuline Church. On October 11, 2001, the remains of Montcalm were removed from the Ursuline convent and placed into a newly built mausoleum in the cemetery of the Hôpital Général de Québec.